Hi guys, let's focus in this video on some particular aspects you need to know to treat a case like that. This is a very difficult and tough case because you have no keratinized tissue at all. So the first concept you know to need is that the tissues are very, very weak. So also the horizontal incisions you see are made in alveolar mucosa. You are not performing incisions in keratinized tissue as you are used to, and so you need to be very, very careful in the procedures. You need to be very careful in keeping the flap with the tweezers, and you need to use surgical tweezers, no anatomical tweezers, because in the anatomical tweezers the flap sweeps and you lose it. You have to press a lot with the tweezers and you may damage the flap. You need some teeth on your tweezer to be able to keep very well the flap and use very, very few strength. Then you also have to be very careful in raising the full thickness flap apical to the recession, because you don't have any sulcus, so you have to be very, very careful because you could damage your flap. It is very difficult to get a full thickness flap in the apical portion of the recession. The second concept is that you have to do your best to eliminate the muscular insertions, both the deep one and the superficial one. You see, it's very difficult to start the muscular insertion incision because also the first incisions are inside the muscles, but you see that we need to eliminate the insertions from the deep and from the superficial. In that way you have, as you can see in the video, the muscles that are independent from the superficial mucosa. So when we will pull down the superficial mucosa to cover the connective tissue graft, the muscles will stay deep in the fornix. And the third concept you need is that in a case like this you need to improve the quality of your tissue, and you have to do that not with artificial tissues like collagen matrix, because they don't work in cases like this. You need autologous connective tissue, and you need the real connective tissue, not fat, not glands, but really white connective tissue to put underneath your flap. You see the white color of the connective tissue in my video. Also, the connective tissue has to be very, very thin, not to damage the aesthetic of the patient. So a very thin connective tissue, white and very well shaped in the dimension you need. The fourth concept is to start the sutures from the apical portion of the vertical incisions. You need to give the last suture, the sling suture, without any kind of tension, because you are used to give the sling suture, the one you are watching now, in the keratinized tissue, where in these cases you are giving it in alveolar mucosa, so the tissue is very weak and it could damage the flap. It could perforate the flap with the tension. So you need to eliminate any tension starting from the apical part of the vertical incision. And this is the 4-month result for our patient. Bye bye, and perform a good surgery.